Okay, hello. Good to have you back. Today we are gonna color a cliffside mansion, and I have here a line art drawn already. It's actually one of my older maps, but I have some spare line art that I use when necessary. Okay, but without further ado, let's get to work. All right, so we have here a line art drawn on a basic notepad with a 7 mm grid. This is just like a regular stock notepad from the local supermarket, so nothing really special. And the pens used for this were pretty basic too, nothing really fancy. So basic line art here. And the first thing that we are gonna do is we're gonna release this background layer by clicking the lock over there, so it becomes layer 0. Then we'll make a empty layer. That's gonna be our background layer again. And then we'll set the canvas size to letter size, and we'll add there some bleed, so 8 by 75 and 8.75 by 11.25 inches. And we can check right away that from the image size that we have resolution of 300 pixels per inch. That's good enough for like printing basically, and we can scale that down very well to virtual tabletop sizes. All right, but now we can see that we have here a Yeah, we got the canvas is a bit oversized compared to the line art. That doesn't matter. It's actually a very good thing that we have some spare room outside the line art. First thing that we are gonna do is before we resize this here, we're gonna use a to fill here, and we're gonna use a 10 mm grid that I have here as a preset. Okay, boom, it's over there. But as said, this is a 7 mm grid that we have here in the line art, so we'll resize this by pressing Ctrl T and then 70%, so that matches the 7 mm scale. And as we can see, it like drops down to this pretty much same size as the line art here. Okay, now we're just setting the grid that it's in place nicely. Okay, close enough. All right, yeah, it looks good. Next up, we're gonna hide the grid layer, and we are going to get rid of any extra stuff here on the sides, like there's like a binder. Oh, there's something happened over there. Let's just back up a bit. All right. Oh, we are doing fine. Just like there's a polygonal select tool that we are using. Over here. There we go. Now Shift Control I inverts the selection, delete the rest of it. All right. This is basically our sketch. We are going to make it look a bit nicer, but we are gonna still do some cleaning up here. Okay, so now we're determining the black, like the blackest pixel that we can find. Then the white pixels. So we get really can't see any grid or extra lines anywhere anymore. Great. Okay. Then we go to channels. We have all channels selected. Like so, we can like select them or one of them. Then we make a selection. There under Shift Control I again. Shifts the selection or inverts it, sorry. And here we create a new layer. We can hide the old one just to show it better how it works. And we are gonna fill this with black 100%. We are not gonna preserve the transparency. And there we go. Now we have like a nice clean line art without any white areas. But we are not done yet. We go to paths and press Alt and select this. This is a path from selection. And tolerance of 2 is, in my experience, pretty good. Works for most of my maps, at least. Okay, now we have here like we have path made out of, or like a vector map path made out of the selection, and it's gonna do an interesting thing to the line art. It's gonna kind of clean it up a bit, but not quite as you would think. Let's create another layer. Because it like smoothens out all the curves and lines, making them into mathematical curves. Sometimes I use the, okay, let's like Control D removes the selection, and let's put white, not quite white, okay, something like that, light gray. All right. Grayish at least. Now we can see that the lines, they are not like rough at all. They are pretty smooth, clean, sometimes maybe a bit too clean. And what I usually do is I have the previous layer that was just the fill layer made out of the channels, and then I'll add it there. And gives this like a nice little rough look. But sometimes it's better to have it cleaner. It's a bit like a situational. Depends on the map, I guess. All right, but for this map, we will go with wait a minute. Actually, this looks pretty good with the vectors. There's really no like right or wrong answer to this. This is just how you like it. Let's make it. I feel that this clean line is better for this one. So let's go with that. Okay, let's put them all in one group. Call it line art. So we are saving still all the other line art layers, just in case we need them. All right, let's move on. Now I want to actually adjust these a bit. So okay, forget what I just said. We are actually going to make some changes on this one layer only. It's gonna change things a bit. No, it's not like a copy of the other layers anymore. I would have to do the same thing. Usually I merge those layers, but okay, now we might need the grid just to align it correctly. Okay. There we go. Just wanted to have a bit more room between these two levels here. Oopsie. Okay, let's make things a bit simpler. This here like that. Now we can move these and we can also resize them as we like. Make them a bit bigger, for example. All right. Nice. Next, I want to have both of the levels. I want them to have separate background. I'm thinking that should I follow the grid here or just no, I'm not gonna follow the grid. I'm gonna do it like that. Then here we are gonna choose a white background, and now we have here this layer is this one, and we press the Alt key and select the move tool, so we can actually move this like so. And now Control T, and we are again adjusting the size of the layers here. All right, now we have two distinct levels. And can hide the grid again, assuming we don't need it right now. Let's align this a bit more. It seems that it's not quite there. I think that looks a bit better. Lower look. Oh. Okay, now they look nicer. All right. Then we could move these here, and now we are gonna align this whole thing in the middle of the canvas, like so. Okay, next. Now we are gonna start to move to the actual coloring. And we're gonna handle this as one layer. We actually need these over here. Cannot have them there. Got these together into something called background. And then we create a new group called or folder called colors. But before that, we are gonna work on the shadows. Okay. switch to the pen. Oops, that's the can. Sometimes I need to have some beverages while drawing. Makes it more relaxed. Not that I'm an alcoholic or anything, but it's just an occasional drink. In this case, some dry apple cider, actually. All right. I obviously still the tutorials on. I don't know why. One moment. Okay. Yeah, so we are gonna draw the shadows here, and for that we are gonna choose the brush that's I want to have pretty sharp shadows. Maybe like, maybe not super sharp, but sharp still. Okay. And this layer we are going to call Shadow 1. And that's going to be a multiply layer with around 30, 40 opacity. Let's put 30 now to start with. The color I usually choose is like a blue scale, but like very dark. This one here is like a 11, 13, 30. We could put it like a 10, 10, 30, and we are quite happy with that, I think. We have the shadow layer below the line art. We could use it, do it like the other way around, but usually I like that the line art is not affected by any colors or shadows or anything like that. So it stays quite clean. Don't care about the windows right now. We're just gonna make this rough shadows here. Starting to have some noise. Oops, nice depth effect there, right? Some kitchen furniture, and what is it called? Like a it's not kitchenware, but like, well, I guess it's like kitchen furniture. All these stoves and refrigerators and so on. Oh, there is seems to be a fireplace too. Nice. Well, this is a luxury mansion, so I'm not surprised. This map is, by the way, inspired by Tony Stark's mansion from the Iron Man movies. Okay, and the outdoors. So we are gonna have here a tree. And now we can like play with the shape of the shadow. So that it becomes more obvious that hey, it's actually a tall tree. It's not like just like a short stump or a bush. Can add there some shape so that it looks like it actually has like more branches and leaves. If you catch any of the sounds from my headphones, I'm actually like there's a movie playing on the background. I often like when I work, I like to have something like a series or a movie running there on the background. Just like helps me to concentrate. I happen to have a bit problems with that thing, and well, I've learned my ways to cope with stuff. It might seem rude sometimes, like if I'm in meetings or whatever, I'm like drawing on paper or doing something else, but that actually like even if it sounds a bit funny, it actually helps me to concentrate. And a lot. All right. So now we have here something like that. Okay. And there's like a some sort of fancy statue. Then we have the stairs. What to do with those? Just like very light pressure, like pressing too much. All right, that's nice. Okay, what do you think? Pretty, yes. Yeah, that looks nice. Let's make that a bit bigger so it looks more like an actual statue. Okay, downstairs then. Okay, so now we could do here so that we like shade this whole area, which is solid, but not quite sure if I want to do that because it messes up with the actual shadows. So I'll leave that up. Oh, we have sauna here. Okay. So downstairs has like a shower and sauna. And then I got a workshop. I bet Tony Dark. Stark had a sauna. He was very conscious about, like, he's a smart guy. And there's even studies nowadays that sauna helps you to recover from stress and physical stress, like a workout. Okay. Oops. So got TV or movie theater, home theater. Yeah, sofa. Screen over there. Water so far. Okay. And then the bedroom. Downstairs bedroom. Okay. And a small library slash home office. And this, all this here is a big, big window. Make that nice. There, some shadow. Well, why not here? Even though if it's a window, we wanted to have some feel. Feel of actually being something like solid. Alright. There it is. Alright. So we have the line art and the shadows done. Looks nice already, something that we could actually use as a printer-friendly version. Add it with a grid, even better. Okay. Next, the actual colors. And here, what we are gonna do is that we are gonna take this out on there. Okay, and now we create a layer here. Okay, nice. And now we start applying the lowest layer of color, and that's going to be in this case maybe the ground. Yeah, or actually the ocean below. So we'll name the layer ocean. And we want this to be like a nice blue ocean, something where you really would like to swim and what you like to watch while working. I wouldn't mind watching that kind of nice ocean myself right now. And from the color dynamics, we are gonna set the the brush settings, we're gonna set the color dynamics on, and this means that now when we draw here, like every stroke is a bit different. When we start a new brush stroke, different. Right. And what the color dynamics does, it changes the color, hue, and brightness, making this like more natural looking. As you can see, nice little effect. There's not much control, like how much it changes the hue or brightness, but this creates more natural looking water, for example, as you can see. There we go. It's not perfect, but good enough, I think. There's a nice rough feel to it. And we don't care right now that the color goes a bit over the borders there, because I'm gonna show you in a bit. Mask and boom. All of a sudden, you don't have to worry about the edges anymore, because it naturally clips the layer based on this lower layer here. Alright, we have the ocean there. Nice. Next, we need the solid. Ground over here. Actually, I'm thinking that it could be maybe better to it so that. No. Switching to green. For a really long time I was very uncertain about using colors, because I have a slight color blindness, very like common with male genes. So nothing really special in that sense. But still made me a bit uneasy with using colors, because I've always felt that there's something wrong that I really cannot or can't select or choose the proper colors. So maybe a bit bigger so we can faster apply the color over here. You're gonna add some other colors very soon. Okay, this is just like the first layer. Then we vary the colors a bit. Maybe a bit like a maybe grayish. Again, color dynamics is good. Always helps. And there, just like some blotches of color, just to make it more natural, make it look like it's actually something that's maybe seen a bit drawn, something like that. Then back to greener again, just a bit like. Be a bit darker, deeper green. Okay, this may be a bit too saturated, so let's go
dark side.
Sometimes, like now that we have the color dynamics on, it's not exactly sure what kind of color we are gonna get from the brush. This is fun, just like experiment, see what happens. Sometimes things don't always go like you plan them to. Let's not worry about it. As it said back, they are happy accidents. Okay. And here. Because we're talking about like a tree leaves and nature. We don't care if it's not like completely even with the lines, there can be some variation changes. Okay. Easy taps over there. Oh, okay. Just brighter color. A bit uneven dots of varying sizes, so it creates the impression of like there's actually some kind of canopy with like complex leaves and such. And now we want to have also like a darker color. We are gonna put it here where we think that there could be shadow. Little by little, I'm adding like layers of colors. This is all on the same layer, so in that sense, start. Changing the opacity a bit. So we are actually just like adding some hues over here, over there, everywhere. We are gonna make a better contrast between the trees and the grass. And now our magic ingredient. Blend a bit the colors. I think these trees need a bit darker color still. Maybe a few dots of a brighter green. Changes in the color, the tone. Alright, now we have this set up, so now we can actually add another layer of color. First, we're going to take that as a reference point and select a bit darker color. Okay. Again, like a bit, and now remember that we have like the opacity of 30, which means that every tap is only 1/3 of the color opacity that it could be. Also need to remember that this is not like the main subject matter of this map. This is just like something on this side. In other words, we are not gonna waste much more time on this. Just one more quick layer of brighter green. Maybe smaller, add it to where it really matters. Actually raise the opacity a bit. Lightly here and there. Okay. Here and there and the grass. Yep. Works fine. Good. Next. Flow 76. Let's have it like that. Big bigger brush. Important questions arise, like what kind of color I'm gonna choose for the statue. Okay, again. Smudging the edges. Okay. That's nice. I think we could actually add here a bit. Some shadows. Next floors, or actually the front porch. I'm gonna make it a bit lighter. Again, you can see that we have the color dynamics on, and again, we are gonna smudge, blur it a bit. then the interior toilets are gonna have pretty much white, and now we can actually hide the shadow so we can really see where the borders really are. Excuse me. Ooh. What did I do? Oh. Then the upstairs and floors. Oh yeah, the statue. That's gonna be gray. Pretty gray. Gray, white gray. It's gonna be maybe something completely else than gray. Nice. What are the floors gonna? What kind of color? Yellowish? Light grayish? Yeah, maybe. Maybe light grayish. detail colors later. Windows, for example. It's simple, it really adds more to it. Let's see. I find it better than solid surfaces. There's nothing wrong with solid surfaces really, but I like my maps with some texture. And again here, we're gonna clean up the edges so we can be quite liberal. It's not worry if little accidents happen, that's just fine. Now so we suddenly have a surface that's not completely even. Some changes in the color tones and looks also like luminosity or something. Okay, now we have the basic floor colors there. Next up here we are going to add bigger brush so we can add faster these edges here. go. Okay. And now we're gonna dive in. Just push size accordingly. First, we want to make sure that all the edges they are covered. There isn't any like nasty spots missing the color like that. Maybe not the best color for rock. Let's not worry about it right now. Now we need to fix that. Some rocky cliffs here too. Like so. Okay. Shadows. Thank you. Okay. Shadow here too. The lower floor below the one that's on top of it. Obviously. Usually lower floors are below the upper floor. But you never know. Things might be really crazy sometimes. Okay, I want to have the balcony a bit different colored. Let's put there. Actually have the borders. Next, we are going to clean up these walls here. Okay, looking better already. Right. Nice. Let's have a look. Not bad in my opinion. Let's do a trick. We'll add a stroke over there around the boxes, and certainly we have really nice borders over there. There we go. Okay, I'm gonna keep this simple. I'm gonna just add some details, and that's it. Kind of want to add, well, yeah, I'm gonna add a highlight layer still. Okay, so let's take a swatches here and start adding some color. 30 the size of the brush. So okay, sorry, let's go back a bit. We want to have a layer called, there we go, and back to the swatches. It's just like a quick palette of different colors we can choose. Again, we need to hide the shadow so it doesn't mess up with the coloring. It can easily hide some details. I'm gonna use the same color for most of the furniture. This kind of wooden color. Not like mahogany, but there we go. Nice. Kitchen table can be different colored. It could be something quite light actually. While the chairs could be maybe blue. That's a weird selection of colors. Stairs. There we go. Okay, like so. Let's see how it looks with the shadows. Not bad, I think. Same thing here. Always check that you got the right layer. Too many times this happened that the layer hasn't been the right one, and then you have to like hunt it down. Which layer is it, and how much you actually caused some damage by having something on the wrong layer? Yeah, you will learn.
Blue couch. Whoever would like to have a blue couch? Well, obviously this. Who owns this place? Whoever that might be. Not worrying too much about the colors. But just that, like, the image somewhat, so it doesn't look all like a big circus. Additional color because it's something special. I don't know what it is, but it's certainly something special. Shadows again, so we can see how it looks now. What this might need now is some kind of texture layer
over the colors. We get just add some kind of looking for something that has like a bit like a static feel to it, but not like exactly static, something that try that one. Okay, this is a bit of an experimental thing. Not really sure what I'm trying to achieve here. Something like that. Tone down it a bit. Okay, now it looks actually like there's some kind of texture on the floor and everywhere. Gives it a bit more character. And I said, this is enough for this map. We are gonna add one more layer, which is called light. And that's going to be a lighten layer, could be also screen with 40 opacity. And we're gonna pick a color that's like something very warm, almost white, but not quite. And Fifty hardness, 15 size. Okay, and we're not gonna bother with the trees so much because they already have some highlights. So we're gonna just add a few little dots here and there. To emphasize the impression of like having these tree lines here. It's gonna help separate these a bit better. Nice. Here, here, over there. Boom, boom.
That was a good idea. Not gonna do it like that. Some light here and there. Bring it a bit more this like not 3D effect, but like that's what it looks like it actually. There's like a light hitting it. This sounds to clean up. Get it done. Oh yeah, windows. But let's handle this first. The lights. I think this is here. That's pretty much done. Maybe we add a little something here. The shadow color gradient round to reverse that. Okay, and then that. So texture sure how this paper really fits the theme, but let's not worry about it. It's just to add some flavor.
good enough. Maybe. And I often like to reduce the color up to like 80%, so it removes some of the excess saturation and kind of like a makes the picture easier to read, in my opinion. All right, so there we go. That was fairly fast coloring, like 1.5 hours. Could have been longer, but I think this map is like good enough like this. And I'll make some final additions, and this is ready for release. Oh yeah, like the grid, for example, I'll place that there. And in general, like check the colors once more and see if I could tone them a bit or something like that. But otherwise, this is pretty much done. Thank you for watching. And see you next time. But before we quit, I'd like to thank my patrons on Patreon, especially Nicholas Buta and Nathaniel Tsai. I apologize if I pronounced your names wrong. And special thanks, and thanks to like many other patrons I have there on Patreon supporting my work. This is really, it really matters a lot. And yeah, that's it for now. Please subscribe to this channel and put the notifications on if you want to be notified of new videos. I'll try to put them out like a few videos per month at least, preferably weekly. And you can find Miska's Maps also on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Patreon, as said. And we have a website also, so please visit that. Okay. Thank you for watching. See you next time.